DDT breaks down into DDE and DDD. 1950 to 1980, DDT was used as an agricultural insecticide.
In the air, DDT will only last about 2 days, but in the soil, it takes about 2 to 15 years to actually break down. So it's not very effective in the air, but in the soil it is very effective. DDT is actually banned, but it's not banned worldwide. Some countries still use it because it's very effective. It lasts for a very long time in the soil. And it's also very cheap and easy to make. Some people ask how toxic it is. It's classified as moderately toxic by the U.S. National Toxicology Program. So it's actually not toxic to humans. Back when it was first developed, they used to actually spray it on humans to help against diseases such as malaria and yellow fever. Alright, so the reason why we think that DDT is positive towards the medical community is because it's cheap, you can make it really easily and fast, and then also because it helps against diseases.
Question for me.
Like, what do you think of DDT?
What do I think of DDT?
Yeah.
Are we talking use here in the United States right now?
The worldwide.
Worldwide. As it kind of comes back to the not my backyard. So DDT someplace else might be okay, but oh goodness, ultimately we have a overpopulated world.
It's a mixed bag. Some things are very, very good, some are very bad. I think in some parts of the world where malaria is a problem, spraying mosquitoes with DDT has, I suspect, saved thousands and thousands of human lives because there weren't as many mosquitoes around to spread malaria.